Welcome to your BiteSize Basics session, designed for seniors to improve your digital skills, brought to you by AbilityNet in partnership with the BT Group. I'm Lizzie Green, and I'm the Workplace and Education Inclusion Consultant at the charity AbilityNet. And this is a short video focused on an introduction to QR codes. First, let me introduce you to AbilityNet. At AbilityNet, we're a charity passionate about digital inclusion, ensuring no one is left behind in a digital world. And we help people aged 65 plus to improve their digital skills in partnership with the BT Group. At AbilityNet, we support older people and disabled people with technology. We have a helpline on 0300 180 0028, where anyone older or disabled can call for advice on technology. We have an amazing team of over 450 tech volunteers across the UK, and they give up their free time to help older and disabled people at home with their technology. And in partnership with BT, we're offering digital skills training in selected regions across the UK. We also have a whole host of free online resources to help you make the most of the digital world. These include fact sheets, free webinars, and a handy tool called My Computer My Way that has a library of over 500 guides offering step-by-step instructions to make your device easier to use. So what is a QR code? Well, QR is short for Quick Response Code, and it's an image that's made up of black and white squares or pixels in a square that stores data for a machine to read. They work in a very similar way to barcodes. So a QR code can store information like web addresses, phone numbers, or up to 4,000 characters of text that someone can send to you. So how do we scan a QR code? So most smartphones will have a QR scanner built into them already. To use these, you open up the camera on your phone, line the camera up with the QR code on the screen, and then a link should appear on the screen that you can tap and will open up to the page it wants to take you to. On the image on this slide, you can see that we have the QR code in screen and the link has come up in a yellow box that we would tap to access the site. If you have opened up the camera on your phone and it is not scanning the QR codes for you automatically, this might be because you have a slightly older phone or you're using a slightly older operating system that doesn't allow for this. What you can do is download an app to help you scan these QR codes. On the slide here, we have popped on the Google Lens app and the Gamma Play QR code scanner. These are just a few of many apps that are available to scan QR codes for you. If you open up your Play Store or your App Store on your phone or tablet and search for QR code scanners, you will get lots of options there that you can download. Once you have downloaded one of those apps or you are using your camera, it might be a nice idea for you to pause the video here and have a go at scanning the QR code on the right hand side of the screen. This QR code is going to take you to the AbilityNet website and is a good way to have a practice of using those QR code scanners. So are QR codes safe? Well, considering that anybody can create a QR code and have it point to any online destination they want, there is some room for scammers to take advantage of the technology. In a similar way to emails, scammers could use QR codes to take you to scam apps or websites. So there are a few things that we need to be mindful of and be looking out for when using QR codes. For example, if you see a poster on the side of the building that's encouraging you to scan a QR code and fill out a form to win a prize, these things are often too good to be true because they are. So we really want to be thinking about where we are seeing these QR codes before we use them and be looking out for some things to look for when we are using them. So with this in mind, we need to make sure that any QR code you're about to scan is being presented to you by a reputable source. So a QR code that you see on an entrance to a well-known restaurant or on their menu inside the restaurant is going to be safer than an unmarked code that you might spot on the window of a bus stop, for example. Also, like with scam emails, it's important for you to take your time with QR codes, check where you found them, and check over what information they are asking for from you before you hand over any of your personal information. So that brings us to the end of our mini bite-sized session today, brought to you by AbilityNet in partnership with BT. If you need any further digital skills or support, please call the helpline on 0300 180 0028 or email inquiries@abilitynet.org.uk. Thank you.